Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be talking to you about posture. In the survey that I sent out, I asked how long you sit throughout the day and what city you stay in the majority of the day, which is totally normal. We're college students, so we spend most of our time doing homework. So I found a study by Michael Haller who looked at sitting posture and the correct way to sit. And he said that workers spend an average of 50,000 hours throughout their lifetime working just sitting, which I think is pretty crazy. And about 40% of people who have an office job have back pain. And most of you said you have some back pain or neck pain. So I'm gonna start about talking about the different types of posture, how posture can affect your body, and how we can improve posture. So the different types of postures are listed here and shown in these photos. And the lordotic posture is this first photo, more in the lower back region. And it's known as the cheerleading posture. So you have an extreme arch in your lower spine, and it causes a lot of compression in that lower back area. And as well, you can have a combination of postures. So if you have an arched lower back, sometimes your upper body compensates for balance, and you start to have that curve, which is that kyphotic posture. And shown up here, which is kind of known as hunchback, so like sometimes you see like older people with like really punched over posture as you age. And having the kyphotic posture can cause, it can be harder to breathe more deeply into your lungs because you are closing in your chest. And we have flat back posture, which isn't very common now, but it's usually called the guy posture. It's just, you have a straight spine, no curves. And then a forward head, which creates a lot of strain on your neck, which can cause some neck pain. And then here's the sway back posture, which is a big epidemic now because all we do is spend time sitting. And all it is your hips are forward over your ankles, so you're really sitting in your rib cage and just letting everything hang on your body, which causes a lot of more compression on your lower back. And through my Pilates training from PHI Pilates Studio, from Chrissy, from Andy Ruby, I have learned about these postures. So some side effects about bad posture is you can have loss of muscle, back pain, as I mentioned before, and also affects on mood. So going to loss of muscle, I watched a webinar by a spinal orthopedic surgeon named Jocelyn Edema, and she mentioned that most of her patients obviously have like some more of a sedentary lifestyle, which they don't move very often, and loss of muscle is atrophy. So this means as you're sitting and you're not moving, she says every 20 minutes you lose a section of your muscle, which is called a sarcomere, which is a very small part of muscle, so don't worry too much, but it can cause loss of muscle, which can cause those different postures I mentioned earlier. Also, the back pain, the pain is happening because we have weak supporting muscles, and all your limbs are attaching to your core, so having a weak core can cause some imbalances there. And going on to mood, there was a study done by Johans Nicolaus, who looked at postures and mood. So they looked at the slumped over posture, which was the kyphotic posture I mentioned earlier, and an upright sitting posture, and they had a series of questions they would ask and recorded the participants' responses, and most of the people in the slumped over posture had a more negative response than the people in the more upright position. Alright, so how can we improve your posture? Well, Pilates is one way. I'm kind of biased because I'm a Pilates instructor, but it's great because why? Because it works on your abdominal endurance, which, like I said, everything is connected to your core. It also works on muscular imbalances. So you're stabilizing muscles that help you, the small ones that you don't work at the gym, it can help you be more aligned. So that's how it can help. Also, sitting properly and moving around. So we're going to do a little activity. We're going to learn how to sit correctly in our chairs. Because most of you said through the survey that you do your homework sitting in a chair. So we're going to make sure that your hips are laid back in your seat as comfortably as you can. And these seats obviously don't adjust down, so if you can, get your feet flat on the floor. We want those knees parallel to your hips. So we don't want our knees touching or too wide. And we want our arms to be adjusted to where it's comfortable. So we don't want to feel like we have to hold our shoulders up all the way. We just want them relaxed, and then also to take breaks when needed. Study said that standing desks really help, which obviously in college you don't really have those, but just trying to change your position throughout the day whenever you're doing your homework can help improve your posture. So thank you. learning about posture, and the next time that you're doing a working find yourself in a bad posture, you will find yourself.